In this video, I want to explain how to design and simulate a coronary for an insulator string. Stay with me. Hi, my name is Mohammed and this is the High Volt Academy channel. If you recall, we've already talked about how to simulate a high voltage insulator string under clean and polluted conditions. Today I'll show you how to add a coronary ring to that simulation, and we'll also talk a bit about how to choose or optimize the best ring dimensions. I'll continue my previous simulation in the video titled How to Simulate High Voltage Insulators in COMSOL, a Beginner's Tutorial. You can access that video from the link above. And if you haven't seen it yet, I strongly recommend watching it first. Okay, this is our previous simulation file. Before adding the coronary ring, I want to first add an infinite element domain around our geometry. Let's get back to our geometry. Here we have our insulator and the surrounding air. I want to add infinite layers at the outer boundary to model a very large surrounding area. I've already discussed infinite element domains in detail in another video here, and since you've mentioned it in the comments, I'm including it in this video. To add layers to this geometry, I open my geometry tree. This is the rectangle representing the air. There is an option here called layers. No layer is defined yet. I want to add a 10 centimeter layer. I click 10 and enter. And I want to add this layer on the right side, top and bottom. So I check layers to the right, layers on bottom and layers on top. If I click on blitz selected, you can see that these layers have been added and our geometry is updated. Now go to definitions. Let's close geometry definitions. Right click on definitions and here you have the option infinite element dom. If there's already another infinite element domain defined, delete it. Then select the domains that will act as the infinite element domain. And don't forget to set the type to cylindrical because we are in a 2D axisymmetric model. Once done, you can recompute your model to include the infinite element domains. Now for the second step, adding the coronary ring, go to geometry again and here click on build selected. The geometry is built till here. Now go to the geometry tab and add the option circle. Because later I want to perform a parametric study on the coronary ring dimensions, I'll define these values as parameters. I name them radius, set to R to diameter and Z to height. This specifies where the ring is located along the Z axis. The sector angle should remain 360 because we want a full circle. You'll see these three parameters are red because the software doesn't recognize them yet. You can also see the unknown model parameter here. To fix that, go to the global definitions here. There's an option called parameters, or right click to add this option. Type the name of your parameters and their value. I do that here. I let the description empty, that doesn't matter. You should evaluate your geometry to ensure that these values are suitable for your model. Now if you go back to your geometry, you can see that these parameters will turn black, meaning they are recognized by the software. If you click on build selected, you can now see the position of the coronary ring. After revolution, it becomes a full ring. Finally, click on build all and our geometry is ready. I haven't run the model with the coronary ring yet, so the current results are only for the previous simulation without it. Under the data set, if you recall, we have defined a cut line. I set these values to 10. And this is the new line along which I want to study the electric field distribution, comparing the cases with and without the coronary ring. We have already plotted in our previous video. Go under 1D plot group. This is the electric field distribution. Notice that the x-axis is arc length. To change that, just click on line graph. Come here under the x-axis data and change arc length to expression and type the expression Z to represent the geometry. plot again. You can now see the electric field from around minus 60 cm to about plus 5 cm along the cut line. This helps us to recognize that this side is the high voltage side of our insulator and this is the grounds. Okay, I also want to keep the previous results to compare the cases with and without cornering. To avoid overwriting, you should add another study. Right click on your model and here click on add study. We need a frequency dominant study, and like the previous one, I set the frequency to 50 Hz and close this window. Now let's set up the new domain and boundary conditions. Come here under the electrostatics. Remember in the previous simulation I told you to exclude conductors from the simulation domain. The coronaring is also a conductor, so make sure to exclude it as well. Also, the coronaring has the same potential as the pin here, so under electric potential, you should also add your coronaring boundaries, so it shares the same potential. That's it for the setup. We're ready to compute. Now, under the study tool, right click and click on compute. Okay, our results are ready. When viewing the results, make sure to select the correct dataset. Let me close electrostatic and also our model. Under datasets, you can now see two datasets, solution 1 and solution 2. This is for the study 1, the case without the coronaring, and this is for the case with the coronaring. To compare both, you should duplicate the cut line because this cut line uses the study 1 as the dataset. Right click and click on duplicate, and here I changed the data set to study 2, solution 2, which is the case with the coronaring. And here also under the 1D plot, we need to duplicate our line graph. Right click, duplicate. And here also under the data sets, instead of cut line 2D1, I select cut line 2D2 and click on plot. The blue one is the case without coronaring, and the green one is the case with coronaring. If you want to differentiate that, come here under the legend, click on show legend, and instead of automatic, set it to manual and set this legend to with coronaring. You can also do the same here for the first one. Now the graph is more understandable. You can notice that on the high voltage side where we have the coronaring, the electric field decreases, while on the ground side the electric field increases. This makes sense because the integral of E.dl must remain equal to the potential difference, which has not changed. You can also see the distribution of electric field. Just click here. This is the case with the coronaring, and if you change it to study 1 plot, you can see the case without the coronary. Okay, now I want to study how different ring dimensions affect the electric field. Let's get back here. What matters most is the electric field near the high voltage pin, especially at the triple points here and here. And to monitor this, I'll add a probe in a specific area. I only need to monitor the electric fields here. So I come again under the geometry, right click, add another rectangle, set the width and height to 25 cm, and set the corner coordinates to 0 and minus 70. I click on build selected. This creates an area around the last insulator unit for targeted electric field study. Okay, now under the definitions, right click, there is an option probe, and select the domain probe. I set the type to maximum because I'm interested in the maximum of the electric field. In the source selection, first I clear the selection, then I select only the domain that I'm interested in. And I also change the expression to electric field norm. Under electric, here is the electric field norm. And now everything is ready. I run study 2 again. Now under the derived values, you can notice the domain probe. I set the unit to kilovolt per millimeter because it makes more sense to me. And here I clear tables and click on evaluate. You can see that the maximum amount of electric field in that area equals 1.8 kilovolt per millimeter. To see where this maximum occurs, you can come here under the electric field norm, right click under more plots, there an option called max mean surface. Under the expression, change it to electric field norm. If we click on plot, you can see the maximum and minimum of electric field, but overall I only interested in this, so I come back to electric field norm. And under the selection, instead of entire geometry, I set the domain and manually select my targeted domain. Now if I plot that, you can see that the maximum of electric field happens in the triple point of the ceramic port, air and metal port. Okay, after defining my probe, finally I want to perform a quick optimization. I'll use a parametric sweep under study 2, right click and select parametric sweep. For the first parameter, I select the height and define a range from minus 50 to minus 70 in minus 10 centimeter steps. For the second parameter, I want to study the effect of diameter of the ring, and maybe I start from 18 centimeter to 24 centimeter in 2 centimeter steps. Don't forget to set the sweep to all combinations, so all combinations of these parameters are studied. Now you can click on compute and wait for the simulation to finish. It may take a little time because it must compute 12 different situations. Click on compute and wait for the simulation to finish. Okay, it's done. You can come here and click on domain probe. You don't see any sign of your parameters. For fixing that, come here under the dataset and change the dataset to study 2 parametric solution. Now if you come back, you can see your parameters. Clear the table and click on evaluate. This might be a problem because we have changed the cornering too much. To fix this one, just come here under the domain probe and remove this domain. Remove that and you should perform your parametric sweep again. That seems like a bug, but you have to comply with it. Okay, we have our results. We don't see the parameters here. Come here, change to parametric solution, and here I only set it to kilovolt per millimeter and click on evaluate, and you'll see the maximum electric field for each combination. You can now compare and find the lowest electric field. In my case, the lowest was for the largest diameter and the highest vertical position. I intentionally introduced the probe because using probes is useful when you want to automate optimization later, but for this case, alternatively, there are simpler solutions. Instead of using a probe, you can use the maximum surface. Right click on drive values, under the maximum there is a maximum surface, and I select the parametric solution and select the domain that I am interested in and select the electric field norm. Clear my table and click on evaluate, and you get the same results here. If it's easier for you, just use the surface maximum option. If you want to design a coronaring, you should check more cases, more combinations, but here it's only a tutorial. I wanted to show you the path. Okay, that's it for today's simulation. I hope this series helps you simulate various insulator string configurations with or without coronaring. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below and I'll answer them gradually. Stay tuned and see you next time.